I'm extremely thankful to Honorable Governor for always encouraging the development of the state, and especially in the social and health sector. On this wonderful evening, I'd like to share with all of you that today, Government of India, which had embarked on a health index with a view to transform states, to transform India under the dynamic leadership of the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi ji, and had given the mandate to Niti Aayog so that there is a totally independent assessment of the state of health, declaration of healthy states, Tamil Nadu has emerged as among the top three states in the country, and we were extremely delighted to share this information with our distinguished chief guest, Honorable Governor. Why I am saying all this is, even in this index, if you look at, as far as the parameters are concerned, next to Kerala, Tamil Nadu is number two as far as neonatal mortality is concerned, or under 5 mortality is concerned, and surprisingly, as far as total fertility index is concerned, Tamil Nadu is lowest, much below Kerala and Punjab. This being a composite index, while we should always strive to be the best, we should accept things as it is and look at areas where we can improve, especially on the aspects of nutrition and on the aspects of sex ratio at birth. Coming back to this wonderful conference and wonderful evening, I would like to tell the audience that Tamil Nadu is one state which allows a holistic approach to this medicine. This is one state where we have respective branches, whether it is allopathy, whether it is Sidda. Sidda is unique to Tamil Nadu. It has spread all over the world. But 90% of the base of Sidda came from Tamil Nadu. Then we have our own Ayurveda, then naturopathy, and Yunani, and of course, homeopathy. So this is one university which has got everything under a single umbrella, which offers a very, very healthy interaction, knowledge sharing, and above all, benefits reaching to the public.
I am happy to be present here today to inaugurate the World Congress on Holistic Health organized by the Tamil Nadu, Dr. MGR Medical University. This conference aims to integrate the various systems of medicine that are practiced for medical treatment in India and abroad, to ensure that the best practices and remedies are gleaned from the wealth of information available so as to benefit the common man. We are all aware that the allopathic system of medicine, as it is understood, combats diseases and infections through the use of drugs or surgery in a manner that brings quick relief to the patients. There are also the traditional system of medicines which aim to treat ailments over a longer period of time and which are also equally effective. While the former may cause side effects or weaken the patient, the latter have minimal side effects and generally do not weaken the patient substantially. We are not here to debate as to which system of medicine is superior. Somebody asked me, which is the best pathy, whether homeopathy, allopathy, Ayurveda, which is the best? Sanika, which cures you is the best for everybody, for you. If homeopathy suits you, for you homeopathy is the best. If Ayurveda suits you, for you Ayurveda is. Otherwise, for immediate relief, allopathy is there. But I am afraid there should be minimum use of antibiotics, because the antibiotic is harmful. There should be minimum use. Doctors should also prescribe minimum antibiotics. The conference is about identifying and integrating the best practices in the various system of medicine to ensure better health care for the common man. You may all be aware that Ministry of Ayush was formed in November 2014. for the development and propagation of Indian and traditional system of medicine. The letters IUS stand for Ayurveda, Yoga, Unani, Sidda, and Homeopathy. In October 2016, India's first All India Institute of Ayurveda was dedicated to the nation by the Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji. All this goes to show the importance that the government attaches to the propagation of the benefits of the traditional system of medicine. At the same time, it is also important to realize that the allopathic system of medicine has its own benefits. Mahatma Gandhi, who was a great believer in naturopathy and herbal remedies, started having faith in Western medicine after his intractable piles problem was solved by surgery. This faith got further reinforced when he was successfully operated for appendicitis in Yerwada jail, where he was interned during the freedom struggle. Based on these experiences, Gandhiji advocated continuous interaction between different medical traditions. Continuous interaction is needed. What I feel, because I am moving throughout the country, allopathic doctor, they generally don't meet and discuss with Ayurveda doctor. This should not happen. Start interaction, joint conferences like this. I appreciate, congratulate you for arranging this conference. This is the need of the time. All the pathies, including homeopathy, everything. It is therefore clear that it is necessary to create a new model for health and healing, keeping the patient at the core of the treatment without being fixated on a single system of medicine. Indian traditional medicinal system like Ayurveda, Siddha and Unani have a well-documented history showing the efficacy of their medicines and treatment. Ayurveda takes the total body matrix to be a combination of the three elements of Vata, Pitta and Kapha. Vata, Pitta and Kapha. These are the three elements. The system aims to create the right balance among the three elements within the human body. The Siddha system of medicine of Tamil Nadu has many similarities to Ayurveda. It is based on a combination of ancient medicinal practices expounded by the Siddhas. The Siddhas were mystics whose knowledge of the human body was profound. Yoga too, in its therapeutic dimension, look at the human system as a holistic whole. Yoga believes that each individual is unique and that he or she should participate actively in the healing process by adopting the right attitude and approach. The entry of homeopathy into India began with the Romanian doctor John Martin Hombirger successfully treating Maharaja Ranjit Singh of the Punjab that time. Owing to wars and military conquests, certain system of medicines were propagated more vigorously and actively by government in the first half of the 20th century. Hence, there was a decline of traditional system of medicine in India and greater focus was laid on the allopathic system. Today, the time has come for us to integrate the system of medicine and not attach too much importance to the deficiencies in any one of the systems. Diseases have become numerous. Lifestyles have become unnatural. Widespread use of substances like plastic, petrol and chemicals has resulted mankind being subjected to suffering and disease to a level and seen in earlier centuries. It is therefore necessary to focus clearly on the enemy of disease and not fight among friends. By friends, I mean various system of medicines. The various system of medicines should be friendly to each other, and their goal should be to eradicate their single enemy, that is disease. The World Health Organization has also emphasized the integration of medicinal system for better universal health care. I am sure that this conference is going to be a path-breaking effort in finding methods to derive the best from the practices followed in the medical world. My best wishes are with Dr. MGR Medical University, who have thought of this innovative idea, and I am sure that all the participants in this Congress contribute usefully towards common goal of fighting diseases. It is necessary that medical care should be effective so as to reduce pain and suffering and increase longevity. It is important that medical care is universally available and within the reach of the common man. And it should be ensured that the medicines necessary for treatment are made available at an economical price. Most importantly, it is necessary well-trained doctors, paramedical personnel are available for treating the patients promptly and comprehensively. I congratulate my expressing my greetings to the entire medical fraternity and wish to assure the medical university, the health department of Tamil Nadu, all the doctors and paramedical personnel of the state, my best wishes are with them for achieving success in all their endeavors. Today I am very happy. Just Principal Secretary Health, he informed me that in the All India ranking, Tamil Nadu has been ranked as third. Congratulations to them, everybody. Try to reach on top. Everything is possible. We have to work hard towards the goal. And secondly, one significant operation detail I was informed. A patient whose both the hands were detached and both the hands have been transplanted and doing well. It's a good news. Good news for everybody. And thirdly, Health Minister has recently informed me that they have started hired a helicopter just for us to be used as air ambulance service. I think will be started first time in the country. Very good. I congratulate you for a good and noble work. So thank you very much. My best wishes to you. You are doing good work. Keep it doing. Thank you.
இந்திய அளவில் 24 கல்லூரிகள் தொடங்கப்படும் என்று மத்திய அரசு அறிவிச்சிருக்காங்க. மத்திய அரசினுடைய கொள்கையின்படி 3 நாடாளுமன்ற தொகுதிக்கு 1 மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி என்பது அவர்களுடைய கொள்கை. நம்ம தமிழ்நாட்டை பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் இந்திய அளவில் மிக சிறந்த மாநிலம். இந்தியாவிலேயே அதிகமான அரசு மருத்துவக் கல்லூரிகள், அதிகமான தனியார் மருத்துவக் கல்லூரிகளை கொண்ட ஹெல்த்தில் நம்பர் 1 ஸ்டேட் வந்து தமிழ்நாடு. அதனால் தமிழ்நாட்டை பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் அந்த புள்ளிவரத்தின்படி நம்ம அந்த இலக்கை அடைஞ்சிருக்கிறோம். அந்த இலக்கை அடைஞ்சிருக்கும் எப்படின்னா, நம்ம 3 நாடாளுமன்றத்துக்குள்ள நம்ம வந்து 1 மாவட்டத்திற்கு 1 மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி என்பது தமிழக அரசுடைய கொள்கை. இருப்பினும் தமிழ்நாடு வளர்ந்த மாநிலம் என்ற காரணத்தை காட்டி 3 நாடாளுமன்றத்திற்கு 1 மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி ஒதுக்கின்ற பொழுது, அப்போ தமிழ்நாட்டுக்கு மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி இல்லை என்ற நிலையிலே எங்களை இல்லை என்ற நிலை உருவாகிவிடக்கூடாது என்பதற்காக உடனடியாக மாண்புமிகு முதலமைச்சர் அவருடைய அறிவுரையின்படி அரசு செயலாளர் மத்திய அரசுக்கு கடிதம் எழுதியிருக்கிறார். எங்களுக்கும் ராமநாதபுரம், திண்டுக்கல், விருதுநகர், நம்ம நாமக்கல் போன்ற 13 மாவட்டங்களில் இன்னும் அரசு மருத்துவக் கல்லூரிகள் தொடங்கப்பட வேண்டும். அந்த அரசு மருத்துவக் கல்லூரிகள் இல்லாத இடங்களில் உடனே அந்த மத்திய அரசினுடைய சார்பில் மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி தொடங்குவதற்கு நீங்கள் நிதியளிக்க வேண்டும் என்ற கருத்தை அழுத்தமாக வலியுறுத்தியிருக்கிறோம் என்பதை உங்களுக்கு தெரிவித்துக்
கொள்கின்றேன்.
இப்போ ஒன்றும் இல்லை.